See, the Lord used metaphors. He used things like flood, wind. So the flood and the winds are situations because you didn't beat your, because you didn't build your spiritual temple upon something strong, man.
Yeah, it's the spiritual demon saying, basically.
Or the spiritual demon saying.
That's what it is. The wind, all right, the prince of the air, you know what I'm saying? The flood, it's the physical counterpart of the spiritual demon Satan, these Edomites, when they shall come in like a flood. So all of it is Satan basically trying you and testing you, shit.
It's just like IUIC, I was telling the brother I had ran into him. You know what I'm saying? One of the things is going out on the highways and byways in season and out of season. I don't never see them niggas no time when it's in the winter. You know what I'm saying? But now all of a sudden y'all out and about. Brother said he seen some niggas.
TLCC.
Another ones are that, like, IUIC, like, you know, and all those like, mother groups. Like, they act all, like, they're the ones who, like, act all, like, hard. Mm-hmm. Like, you see, like, even when we came to, like, the vehicle, you know, there was that one guy who was, like,
Looking
like grape soda and muscle milk or some shit. All right, but if you're that fucking tough, then like what's coming out in sub-zero weather? They're you know those Russians, those are Edomites. Like they're inferior to you, but they can, they probably just like can do something. Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Oh, Socket. Brothers, they're acting hard. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That might be GOCCC, GOCC. You know, but them IUIC niggas is pussy, man. I ran them niggas all the way to the car, man. Just asking them questions, you know what I'm saying, and confounding them with the scriptures, man. Alright? Yeah, can't nobody come up here, you know, if it be the Lord will, can't nobody come up here and make us scatter and go to our fucking car. That'll never happen. But you ask them a couple questions and you confound them, you know what I'm saying? And they like, well, you basically you just hate your brother. That was their excuse. You hate your brother. No, we hate every false way, man. And that shit y'all doing is false, man.
I remember the member of IUIC that that I ran into, he got offended because I wouldn't take one of his like pamphlets or whatever. Or you know, I could have it would have like neutralized the situation if I just like would have like played dumb or whatever. Alright, and said alright, and then just like taking the pamphlet and went about my business, but we were like just like battling back and forth for a little bit, but like he got so offended, right? People have an allergic reaction to the truth. Like when he got back into his car, or he wasn't paying attention to the road, he was still like yelling at me through the car with his, and he had like his wife and kids in there, right? And he was like compromising like their safety, like just to like yell at me. All right, so you know this truth, like it gets either scares people away or they get some like offended, right? To where they end up like, it's like doing something stupid.
That's right, man. Because one of the things that we was arguing about was the name. You know, and they say the name is, first of all, these niggas was at a gas station in the middle of the night preaching the Bible. There's no food out there. You know what I'm saying? But we got into it over the name. They saying the name is just the law, statutes, and commandment. You know, the Most High don't have a name. All right? But the scriptures tell you that. You got to call on his name directly, man.
This is Acts chapter 4, verse 12. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given.
Right, there's none other name under heaven given. It's only one name. All right, it's not a higher, what do they say? A higher, Yeshua, Jesus, Yahshua, all that shit. Yeah, Jehovah, Jehovah, Shem, Yahushua. But IUIC is teaching, they congregation is teaching the people that you don't have to know the Most High name. You know what I'm saying? They say all you gotta do is follow the law, statutes, and commandments. Which you're supposed to follow the law, statutes, and commandments to the best of your ability, but we can't here. We can't do it perfect. Just like the brother said earlier. You can't follow the law perfect. You know what I'm saying? So you're basically saying that all Israel gonna die, because ain't nobody in Israel keeping the law 100%. All right?
Under the heaven given among man, which whereby we must be saved.
But whereby we must be saved, man. So how you not gonna call on Yahweh Hashem Yahusha when this tribulation comes? You gonna pray to the law, statutes, and commandments? You know what I'm saying?
What's going on, man?
I'm speaking. What's up?
All right, but what's going on? All
right. I see what y'all over here doing, and I respect it. Because I'm trying to push the word and all that.
Can you speak up a little bit, sir?
I hear, at the same time, y'all getting mixed communications. Y'all got a lot of things wrong with these signs.
Hey, man.
It's on the right guy.
Go teach the right guy, man. If you don't trust him, go teach him.
I trust him, but I'm saying at the same time.
Go teach.
Look at that sign down there, that last one down there.
Go teach.
The one that brother holding?
I ain't holding. Zechariah.
Let me see that sign that season, man. Destroyed.
Zechariah.
What? Did you see that one?
We're talking about.
Hold on, I got all the signs that we keep it at war. We're talking about the white people. So you come up here to defend the white man.
Hey, hold on. It's all good, man.
I'm just trying to talk. Everybody over here getting hostile because of me. I'm not defending the white man. I'm not defending nobody.
Then what's your purpose? What do you want to know?
I'm just saying the purpose is this.
What's wrong with it?
It's right, but it's wrong.
How is it wrong?
Because this just the signs and stuff.
What's wrong?
White people get ready for y'all. It feels like this shit.
That's not going to happen.
That's not how it's supposed to be.
That's not
going
to happen.
Everybody going to get destroyed. Everybody that's evil, everybody that's wrong going to get destroyed.
What scripture
is
that? What scripture is that?
I see her, my girl. Go teach her, bro. We don't need you. You got two idols around your neck, man.
Come on, hey, man.
That's why you don't need you.
You're not sounding right.
Okay, we don't care about
it, man. I understand that.
Let me get this right quick. This Romans chapter 3, verse 3. Listen, it says, "For what if some did not believe? Shall their unbelief make the faith of the Most High without effect?"
So just because you don't believe, but we say, or you may not believe in the scriptures, that's not God. That's an idol. That's evil.
We about to answer all your questions. All you got to do is listen. Hey, Akio, he want to know who wrote the book, man.
Who wrote the book?
All right. Get 2 Timothy 3:16 right quick. Right.
Who wrote all these
we
books?
We finna let you know, man.
Tell me.
Hey, get, what is that? Job 30:35. What you got?
2 Timothy 3:16. Let's talk him first.
Y'all up here
back. Hold on. This ain't about color, bro. That what you getting misunderstood. No,
it is.
It ain't. This is. Red right there, he look like a white man, right?
He look like a white
man. Why he listening to us then?
It doesn't matter. I'm not saying it's not discriminating.
Why he emotional, dog?
Go ahead. This is 2 Timothy 3:16. All scripture given by inspiration of Yahweh. Said verbatim. All scripture is given by inspiration of God.
So who wrote this book?
All scripture? Do you not understand?
So what, the book fell from the sky?
All scripture?
The Bible fell from the sky?
Is given by inspiration.
Did a white man write this book?
You got a white man around your neck. What are you mad for?
Read it again.
All scripture is given by inspiration of God.
Keep going. And it's profitable for doctrine.
Keep going.
For reproof.
For
reproof. What does reproof mean?
What's reproof?
I'm hearing it.
Man, you don't even know.
Hey, man. Just
keep going, man. For correction. Correction.
Uh-huh.
For instruction. Instruction. The Bible is all the scriptures. What is a scripture?
It says, what's in the book? But who wrote the book? That's what
you
I'm
missing
saying.
The point.
Y'all missing the
point. The prophets, nigga.
Hold on. He missing the point. He missing the point. The Bible just said, read it again. Since he clearly don't, for reproof. Now, start over from the top. All scripture. Start up. He just said scripture in the Bible. Don't leave on that side right now, bro.
So do you not know what you're doing right now?
Hold on.
And you can go to Matthew and read that.
Hold on. One point at a time. Read it again. All scripture.
All scriptures. He said the same thing 8 times. I heard
it. You just said the Bible.
Emotional as fuck.
Yeah. It's emotional. I'm just trying to make a point. Y'all out here trying to preach and get people to view.
Hey, somebody get some rock 6:30. Okay, the brother got a scripture for you.
6:30. Ecclesiastes 5:1.
Yeah.
Keep thy foot when thou goest to the house of the Most High.
Stop right there. He said, keep thy foot when I go into the house of the Most High. What's the house of the Most High?
What that mean to you? You tell me.
Come on, man. Go ahead.
And be more ready to hear.
Oh, be more ready to hear. Uh-huh.
Than to give the sacrifice of food.
The scripture said, be more ready to hear, bro. You're not even trying to hear us.
I'm listening to
you. You can't listen and talk at the same time. Go ahead. Hold on, listen.
For they consider not that they do evil.
See, you considering not that you're doing evil. You talk about what we're doing is a sin, but in our actuality, the shit that you're doing, it's a sin.
It's not.
And you just put
the Bible in your hands. But we
get the scripture,
don't worry
yo.
About it.
Get the scripture.
Don't worry about it.
Hey.
And you got tattoos on your arm. And you standing here.
Get the scripture. I don't
know. Hold on. You don't want to praise God. Go to a room in a dark corner by yourself and praise him because only God need to hear. Why don't you read that?
It's an alphabetical order.
Yeah, hold on. Yeah. Hold on. Go ahead.
Tattoos, that's out of the way. Have the tattoos. That's a sin. Standing in front of a bunch of people preaching, that's a sin.
Go ahead.
I said 8 to 20.
Everybody hold y'all peace, man.
I said 8 to 20 to the Lord and to the testimonies.
Don't lean on the sign,
not according to this word. Hey, you kind of blocking the sign, too.
Actually, move back a little bit, man.
According to this word,
bro,
it is because there is no light in them.
Yeah, read it again.
Why everybody keep cussing with Bibles in their
hands? To the Lord, scripture, the testimonies.
Hey, what is that? Nehemiah, the last chapter. When he cursed Nehemiah, the last chapter. I believe in Nehemiah 16 and 20 something. Get Nehemiah right quick.
Nehemiah.
Nehemiah. The last book, the last chapter of Nehemiah, he's talking about cursing. Hold on. We gonna get this thing cleared up, man. Right? Cause that we out here for, man. Hey, for the people who watch it, we out here to bring our people to edify, to build our people up, to give them the proper understanding of the scriptures. All right, you got the word curse. Read that.
Okay,
yeah.
Hey,
curse, the reverse.
Hold on.
You got two readers.
Okay, come on, read that again.
Curse, the reverse of to bless.
Okay, this is what curse really means. Read it.
Curse, the reverse of to bless.
The reverse of to bless. So the only way that you curse somebody if you wish death upon them, bro. This from, hey, this a so-called white man wrote this. He is a motherfucking, he's a scholar. He's a doctor, right? You do the same some more?
It says, on the human level, to wish harm or catastrophe.
Yeah, it says on the human level, to wish harm or catastrophe. That's what it means to curse. Get that out.
So that's ill will, to wish ill will.
That's what it means to curse. You got that? Corinthians, that rude speech. Get that. You got that?
Nehemiah, what verse is it though?
The last Nehemiah. Yeah. All right, right there, 25. Hold on, no. We got this. You speaking to me right now. We got order. The scripture, if you know the scripture say what? Let everything be done decently and in order. This is our order. I'm the speaker. Read it out.
All right, Nehemiah 13 and 25.
Uh-huh.
And I contend with them.
We contended with them. What does contend mean? You know, like you the number one contender in me. You got it to a brawl with their ass. Go ahead.
Sorry. It says, and curse them.
I thought you can't curse. Hold up. We getting the point across. Is we sinning by using so-called curse words? If
Nehemiah.
Huh? Okay then, we just cleared that up. No.
By curse, you're not supposed to curse with a Bible in your hand. That's disrespectful. Not technically
what
a sin,
scripture
but it's disrespectful.
Is that? What scripture?
It's disrespectful, period. The curse with a Bible.
What scripture is that?
It don't have to be.
It's cool.
Y'all talking about somebody actually being cursed. When I say curse, I mean cussing.
What's
cuss words?
What does cuss mean?
Y'all sitting here reading the definition of somebody being cursed.
Here you go. Listen.
He's going to answer your question.
This is 2 Corinthians 11 and 6. But though I be rude in speech.
Rude in speech, man. Meaning we use so-called curse words. We say bitch, fuck, all right? Pussy, dick, whatever, motherfucker.
It says, yet not in knowledge.
Yeah, so though we be rude in speech, we cussing with the Bible in our hand. We so-called cussing with the Bible in our hand. But we ain't rude. We got the knowledge, bro.
All right? You can't denounce that. You can't debunk it. Go ahead.
It says, but we have been thoroughly made manifest among you in all things.
We thoroughly made manifest among you in all things, meaning the scriptures. We thoroughly made manifest. We know what we're talking about at the end of the day, man.
So no matter what the knowledge is that y'all know, I'm not neglecting. I'm not taking away anything from y'all. Y'all came over here and y'all think I'm being hostile. And now That's not at all. I'm saying I came over here. Whichever way I put it, y'all know what I'm talking about.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? But you saying you got the knowledge don't mean nothing. It's still the point.
Hold
it's,
on.
It's still the point. That, it's still the point that you cussing with the Bible in your hand. Y'all got to talk to me about.
See,
all right.
Now his,
all
right, his first
which
point.
Is not what I was
his first
about.
Point was that the so-called white man wrote the Bible, all right?
Which he
now,
did.
Okay, all right. Now we gonna address that point because we just shut
I
him
mean,
down.
A thousand Bibles
we just, he just agreed
God.
With us. You are a witness, right? He just
I,
agreed that
I
we're not
with
cussing
him.
With the Bible.
You
okay.
You are cussing with the Bible in your hand.
This I'm guy is this guy double-minded.
You gotta respect him.
You it's cool. This weekend in this work, he like a punching bag.
Say, no, deal with the speaker, man.
Stay order, y'all. Stay order.
Deal with the speaker, man.
Anyways, all right, hey, somebody get 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 20.
Just
1 and 20, man.
2 Peter chapter 1, verse 20.
Uh-huh.
Knowing this first.
Oh, okay, you got to know this first. I, go ahead.
Oh, that's
no
bad.
Prophecy of the scripture
yep.
is of any private interpretation. So this mean that the Bible is not of any private interpretation. Mean that a motherfucker didn't sit down have an epiphany, a light bulb went off on his head, and he said, oh, let me write the Bible. Go ahead.
Verse 21.
Uh-huh.
For the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man.
Oh, they just got cut, man. Read that again.
Listening.
Cut. That's cool. It's going out, whether he listen or whether he don't.
Right,
it don't
right,
matter,
right.
man. Go ahead.
For the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man.
So the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, meaning no man didn't write it, bro. Keep going.
But holy man.
Holy men, what the word holy mean?
I know the word. Continue. I want to hear your point, bro. I want to hear your point.
Read 21 again.
Verse 21. For the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man,
uh-huh.
but holy man of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost.
Yeah, holy men of the Most High spake when they was moved by the Holy Spirit. So the Bible was written by men that the Lord put the Spirit on them. All right, he gave them a vision. All right, and that's when they wrote the Bible, man. What you talking about?
Right,
now somebody get go ahead.
I got one.
Okay,
2 Corinthians 4:3. But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost.
Yeah, so if this gospel be hid, all right, it's hid to them that are lost, man. All right?
If the
I
gospel,
gotta go,
man.
If the
it
gospel,
nice
hey,
please,
hey,
please,
hey
please,
get the wicked, the wicked all right, flee all right. with no man, forget that. Read it. Hey,
hold on. Hey, hold on. There's a little bit more.
We hold on. We got one more scripture. Hold on. Go ahead.
It's Proverbs 28:1. The wicked flee when no man pursue him.
He get him on camera.
He's fleeing, man. But the righteous are bold as a lion. He bold as a lion, man.
All right. We going to the scripture. See, niggas always want to hear what our opinion is. This is our opinion right here, man. This is our opinion, man. The wicked flip when no man pursue. That's a wicked ass nigga. He couldn't get his point across. That was the spirit, man. He'll get too many motherfucking scriptures on this nigga, man. He couldn't get his point across. We just spiritually put that nigga in the figure four and choke that nigga ass out. That nigga tapped out, man.
He don't even know the Heavenly Father name to repent. So his death is short, man.
That nigga just, and at the end of the day, he just condemned himself, man.
He didn't bring out the scriptures either.
Go ahead.
This is verse 4. In whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not.
The God of this world, man, all right, which is the so-called white man. He blinded the mind of them, that nigga right there, which believe not. The scripture says, so what if some did not believe, man? We don't care. He telling us we wrong and this and that. Okay, what's your point, man? All right, if we not affecting the way that your life is, man, why the fuck do you give a fuck what we saying out here, man? Is that it?
No.
Go ahead.
It says, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Yahweh shine, who is the image of Yahweh, should shine unto them.
It's the light, man. It's scriptures, man. All right? That's the light, man. They not going to get it, man. Like the brother brought.